Hello and welcome to our YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to show you three simple steps on how to connect and seal two shipping containers joined together to form a house. We will highlight the advantages and disadvantages of each method for better understanding. Stay tuned as we explain the process step by step. Welcome back. If you love shipping container homes or you are planning on building one, our YouTube channel is a one-stop shop for a complete guide on how to design, how to build, how to insulate, and a collection of hundreds of blueprints for container homes designs. In addition, we also cover case studies of the best homes made from shipping containers from around the world. For this and more, feel free to subscribe and remember to click on the bell so that you don't miss out on any of our amazing weekly videos. You can also contact us on our website sheltermode.com or follow us on social media platforms through the links in the description below. Placing shipping containers in parallel side by side is a pretty common scenario when building with shipping containers. The joinery process is not as straightforward as it may sound. The protruding corner posts on the shipping containers prevent a perfect seal when two shipping containers are placed side by side. If you intend to execute this task as a DIY project, you will be required to have tools and materials that are essential to get the job done. We have sampled out a complete list of highly rated and well-priced products and equipment that can be purchased online in the description below. So, without further ado, the following three steps can be used to connect and seal two or more shipping containers joined together to form a house. Step 1. Secure the containers onto the foundation. Generally, the containers should sit on the foundation and hold in place under its own weight. However, for additional security or if you are not planning to relocate the containers, weld the containers to a hold-down steel plate cast in situ with the foundation. Alternatively, you can bolt the containers through the corner plates and hold down with a steel plate. Always have the foundation made level to ensure the containers sit at the same height for proper alignment. Step number 2 is to join the containers together. Once the containers are properly sited on the foundation, the next step is to connect the containers to each other. There are several methods used to connect shipping containers together, including bolting, welding, and tying. First, we look at welding. Welding is the most common and most preferred method of joining shipping containers. You need to ensure the protruding corner posts connect together perfectly as a sign of proper alignment. Use heavy-duty G-clamps to hold the containers in place during welding. Because of the protruding corner posts on shipping containers, they will prevent a perfect seal when two containers are placed side by side. To achieve better results, weld a flat steel plate onto the gap in between the containers using a spot weld on the outside, all round the roof, the floor, and on the sides of the containers to secure the containers together. Next, you need to go over the spot welds with a continuous weld to make the joint more permanent, waterproof, and strong. The next step is to apply a prime paint over the steel plate and the welded joints to keep the connection rust-proof. Welding containers together is advantageous in making the connection much more secure and rigid. However, it is a more expensive method compared to bolting, and it will require prior skills to execute. So the second method to use is bolting. To bolt two shipping containers together, you need to ensure the containers are properly aligned so that the protruding corner posts connect together perfectly. Using industrial strength corner casting bolts, the containers are pulled together and locked into their joined position. You ensure the washers and the bolts are rust-proof for easier maintenance and execution. It is advisable to have the bolts well greased to prevent rusting and for easier screwing. Bolting is a cheaper method than welding, and it is best suitable if you intend to dismantle and relocate the containers in future. The biggest con is that the connected joint is not permanent and is not waterproof. Tying is the cheapest of the three methods of joining shipping containers. Just like bolting, you'll need to ensure the protruding corner posts connect together perfectly in good alignment. Using several strands of heavy gauge rust-proof binding wires, you insert them through the existing holes in the corner posts, and then you twist and tie them tightly together to hold the containers in place. This method is a bit rudimentary and is more of a temporary measure to keep the containers in place. Despite the method being cheaper, it will require quite a considerable amount of physical strength to execute. The third and final step is to seal and waterproof the joints. Because of the protruding corner post on shipping containers, they will prevent a perfect seal when two shipping containers are placed side by side. So the following techniques can be used to seal the joint between two shipping containers and keep it watertight. The first method is to use mastic and spray foam. To keep the joint watertight, you will need to fill the resultant gap with a mastic strip and cover it with silicone to hold it in place. You will secondly put spray foam insulation on the inside to permanently keep the connection watertight. In addition, spray foam insulation will also help to regulate the indoor temperature of the shipping containers. Ensure you put on protective equipment and follow the correct instructions when applying the products. Another method is to use waterproof cement. Shipping container roofs are designed to drain water on the sides of the container walls. In this regard, joining two shipping containers may pose a drainage challenge of water pooling at the center, hence compromising your new joint. The best solution is to raise the center and slope the roof outwards using a waterproofing material like waterproof cement, and cover it with mastic asphalt for additional waterproofing, and then top it up with a silver paint to reflect excess heat. The last solution to waterproofing a shipping container joint is put an additional roof on top of the shipping containers. The most sure way to keep water off your roof is to construct an additional roof over the finished connection. An additional roof will help you to drain water or snow away even before it reaches the containers below. Different types of roofs can be used, like a corrugated steel roof, a planted roof, or even a standard seam roof, depending on your climate, cost, or personal preference. An additional roof can also be good in improving the aesthetic appeal of your shipping container home. We hope you found our presentation informative enough to enable you seal and join shipping containers together for your future house project. Give us your input by posting in the comments below. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up and feel free to share it. Remember to subscribe and see you in the next video.